Recently, ChargerLAB got a 45W power adapter from the well-known company Google. Compared with common chargers, Google's design is quite recognizable, with prongs on a disc base and a rounded body, and it uses GaN technology. Next, let's take it apart to see its internal components and structure. The Google 45W GaN power adapter's gray case is made of fire-retardant PC. The surface of the case is matte, and the sides and edges are rounded. To improve stability, the prongs are on a disc base, and the specs info is printed under the disc. Model is G21GaN. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts 50 or 60 Hz 0.8 amp. The maximum output power is 45 watts. It has three sets of PPS, which are 5 to 11 volts 3 amp, 5 to 16 volts 3 amp, and 5 to 21 volts 2.25 amp. It is certified for level 6 energy efficiency. It adopts the Australian standard plug. It only has a single USB-C port. The size of it is about 49.5 by 58.4 by 28.3 millimeters. Compared with the Apple 35W charger, it is smaller. The weight is about 105 grams. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C port can support PD 3.0 PPS QC4 and DCP charging protocols. And it has four fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amp, 9 volts 3 amp, 15 volts 3 amp, 20 volts 2.25 amp, and three sets of PPS, which are 5 to 11 volts 3 amp, 5 to 16 volts 3 amp, and 5 to 21 volts 2.25 amp. Next, let's start to take it apart and take a look at the internal components. First, pry off the bottom case along the gap, which uses an ultrasonic welding process. The plug is connected to the PCBA module through wires. Take out the PCBA module, and there is a thermal pad inside the case to help dissipate heat. The gaps between components on the front side of the PCBA module are reinforced by filling with potting compound. Clean up the potting compound. The master control chip optocoupler SMDY capacitor protocol chip and output V-bus MOSFET are on the back of the PCBA module. There is the SMD fuse. 3.15 amp. This is the common mode choke used to filter out EMI interference. The bridge rectifier is from YJ and adopts the 3K package. 8 amp 1000 volts. The electrolytic capacitor for input filtering is from Chinks. 420 volts 22 microfarad. The I-shaped inductor is wrapped with an insulating tube. The other electrolytic capacitor for input filtering is also from Chinks. 420 volts 68 microfarad. The capacitor that powers the master control chip is from Chinks. 100 volts 10 microfarad. The GaN IC is from MPS and adopts QFN package. It is a QR flyback regulator GaN FET, which is suitable for high performance and high frequency design. The CT1018 optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The three SMDY capacitors are from TR. They are small in size and light in weight, making them very suitable for use in high density power products such as GaN fast charging. The blue Y capacitor is from SEC. The synchronous rectifier controller marked with IBHJP is from MPS. The maximum operating frequency is 600 kHz. It supports multiple working modes, supports high side and low side applications, and has ringing detection to prevent false activation. The synchronous rectifier is marked with SPL100N070. The two solid capacitors for output filtering are from YX. 25 volts 470 microfarad. The protocol chip is from Weltrend. It has passed the USB PD 3.0 certification of the USBIF Association and has passed the Qualcomm QC 4 Plus certification. It has an integrated 10-bit ADC for voltage and current detection, a built-in 8051 core microcontroller, and a built-in discharge MOSFET. The V-bus MOSFET is marked with B3006. Here is the component list of the Google 45W GaN power adapter for your convenience. It adopts an Australian standard plug and its appearance design is quite recognizable. After taking it apart, we found the plug is connected to the PCBA module by wires. The gaps between components are filled with potting compound and the USB-C socket is reinforced with a steel sleeve. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.